since the deputation. I haven't been here in quite some time, and it's obviously been a long time since I made another video. That's mainly because I've been so absolutely busy with school, with volleyball, with... I now work for the Fillmore Western Railway, so I have a lot of things tied up with that during both the weekend and the weekends, but I've been so busy to the point where I've honestly not been in here into the garage for quite some time. And because of that, I have not worked on many things, not a lot of things to lay out. It changed recently, but actually since the last video, which would have been the Great Train Expo Part 2, along with Part 1, a lot has changed since then. Because I did up until about February, and early March is when I was still working on things and still having time to come out in here and actually do some things. So, I will go through all things that have changed and improved and looked different than the last video. And I'll also try to go in on a lot of the new engines I've acquired and everything, which hasn't been too substantial in the last few months because, like I said, I've been too busy to do anything really with trains. And to be completely honest with you, I lost a lot of motivation and will to come in here and work on things because it kept being, you know, a lot of times when I had back in last year and you know, earlier parts of this year, I had more time to come in here, had more energy and the will to come here, sit down, work on some things, run some trains. But as the last few months, I really have not. So that's why there hasn't been really any videos, nor much a lot of progress as well. As far as what I plan and all that to get done, I honestly don't know. I'm just kind of planning it by week here. My volleyball's done. I've only got about a month of school left before I graduate. There's really not a whole lot for me to say in regards to what else am I going to get done on this thing. But I'll try to explain the best that I can in terms of where we go from here. So let's get started, shall we?
Where I left off in terms of videos was, like I said, back at the Great Train Expo in January. And around that time, I was decently along, I think, with the roundhouse area, the new turntable. Because back in, I can't remember. It would have been probably November-ish, maybe even October, that I tore out my Atlas turntable. You see down here? It's got overspray on it now. Because I had this Walters 90-foot turntable that I bought off a guy off a Facebook group a long time ago for only $20, brand new in the box. A friend pointed out to me, Chris Huffman, pointed it out to me. And so for that deal, even though I didn't have a spot for it at the time, I just bought it. Built it a short while after, but after it was built, it's just been sitting under my lap for quite some time. It originally was going to go over there. I was going to have an extension. It was going to go right to the side of the Siebel Locomotive Workshop. That did not pan out. And after I'd done the trestle project with the waterfall and the hills and all that, I was thinking about, well, what can I do now? Because I've done that big project, and I've added just about as much as I could. So I thought, you know what? The last big thing I'll probably be able to do is install the new turntable. So I pulled all the buildings off, all the track, all the engines, traced out the pit, and used a jigsaw to cut the hole. So cut the hole all the way through, placed this turntable in here. And it's been many weeks laying track, buildings, and wiring it all up. So it's not all the way done. I still have to build a hand crank system underneath for the turntable because right now it just moves freely. So I can turn things, and I did power the bridge. The way it's powered is you have really long wires that are the power supply from the bridge. Sorry, the power supply to the bridge. Via the power on the layout. The turntable lead here, you can see there's these wires go all the way down. There's endless supply of slack. You can't even see, they go all the way up, back up into the bridge, and that's what power, and they're soldered, the wires are soldered to the rails in the bridge, making it powered. So I can get things on and off it, turn it around, and eventually if I ever get to it, I'll have the hand crank system underneath. The way in terms of videos and photographs when I'm turning it, it will look very real. Got four tracks in, as well as the restoration shop and one roundhouse. Got the two diesel servicing tracks, as well as the track will have a water tower. Have not built the base for that yet, and have not acquired and built the second roundhouse yet. But this is just the general overview of how it looks now. Sorry, I didn't really mean to flip it there. And I also re-took out all the crap in the town, swept it all out, and put in a black gravel, kind of similar to road area. And I put the wrought iron fence there to separate the roundhouse area from the town. And quite honestly, I'm very happy with the way it came out. It's a lot more space, a bit more realistic, all around just looks a hell of a lot better. So that is the turntable roundhouse area as of today. Honestly, I don't know, and I don't think I'll buy a roundhouse and build it and get it installed, because it's a couple, it's honestly a couple days worth of track work to build and everything, get it all assembled, so I don't know. Time will tell. As of right now, I don't have any plans to do so. You can see we're back over here at probably the favorite spot of mine on the layout, the trestle waterfall. That patch of white showing through, I need to paint that brown and then put turf back over it. It looks still good. I still want to make some improvements, a little bit on the water and a little bit of touch up here and there. I've dual gauged the bridge, and I've added dual gauged two corners over here. But that's as far as I've gone with the dual gauge, as far as the 3-foot strip by the station that's always been here for a long time. I do have, I think, the rail to do it, to finish, connect this little portion here. That way I'll have about like 40% of the mainline dual gauge. That's another thing I don't think I'll ever fully get done. But we'll see. It's just, there's a lot of things I really can't say, because I just generally don't know what I'm going to get to and what I'm not going to get to. So here's the town area. Here's the crossing here for the station parking lot. I've also changed this area from the, it's like the dead brown and yellow grass to green. The way it all makes it look a hell of a lot better. Change this stupid spot that used to be black to green. That's, these spots are still green. Added a crossing over here. Goes from the shop to the platforms over here. One thing that I do want to do for sure is get the wood fence kit from Probably Roundhouse and have the fence go around this barn there. Country house. And I have a mailbox out here. Make for some great scenes. Something that we did, I think, right about after the Great Train Expo. Honestly, it might have been before. I just can't seem to remember a lot of this crap anymore. Was we made this, which was going to be the future auxiliary shop site, the new coach yard. So we got a 3-track coach yard, and we've got coaches everywhere. I think I believe over 60 or 70 coaches total. So quite a bit. This is a gas station kit from Ray in a trade deal. I have not built it yet, nor do I think I will. But, I mean, I hate to keep repeating this, but I just honestly do not know. But yeah. Other than that, not a ton has changed in this general area. Still have mounds and mounds of projects everywhere. Now, my birthday was on May 1st, which as of today, May 7th, would have been 6 days ago, in case you guys were wondering. And the one thing I bought was this 1972 PFM Pacific Fastmail Brass Union Pacific 280, number 741. I had been browsing BrassTrains.com's YouTube channel, because they post all these test run videos of hundreds and hundreds of HO-scale steam and diesel locomotives in their inventory, all brass. And just browsing through it, I saw this really nice UP280. I fell in love with the look immediately, because it was so beautifully painted. It ran really well. I loved the Vanderbilt tender, and I couldn't get this thing off my mind. But I figured by the time it was on there, it had already been sold. It had been posted a few months ago, this video. So I was browsing, I was thinking about what I wanted for my birthday. And so I browsed BrassTrains.com's HO-scale steam category, and about halfway down, I think I was looking under like under $300, and about halfway down, three fourths of the way down the page, I found this, and once I saw it, I knew. I said, "I'm not looking anymore. This is what I want." So I bought it, and super pleased. I absolutely love this locomotive. Can't beat it. I've cleaned and oiled it. It runs fantastic, just as well as my other brass 280. This one's from United Imports in Japan. They're actually about the same in terms of both being United released, but this one's PFM. And this one is lightly weathered, custom painted. I paid about $275 for it, which I figure I could probably sell for about $300. Got the box and everything. Whoops, sorry. Just being stupid and flipping the camera upside down. I'll give you guys some great angles of this thing running at the end of this video, as well as some other stuff. Yeah, now I've got two brass steam locomotives, ironically both 280s. Detail on this thing is immaculate. As far as other engines I've acquired, I had a nice trade deal with my good buddy Ray, and we exchanged quite a few things. This is probably one of my favorites. A Black Widow Atheron Blue Box Trainmaster, which is very nicely detailed. So I'm trying to get some good lighting on. It's pretty dusty. I haven't run it in quite a bit. But I loved it because I thought it would go really nicely with my Black Widow F units, which are sitting right here. Let's see the Granite Rock 10s in here, along with my Folding Prism number one. As well as here's all the parts for it that I have. Also started working on an HO model of the Fillmore and Western 14, because like I said, I work for the Fillmore and Western now. The 14 and the Folsom 1 builds, honestly I'm not sure that I will finish, and I really don't feel like being bombarded with questions about it and crap all about it, but I'll maybe make a video about the plans and crap for that at another date. Right now, I moved all the stuff off the workbench, which is way over there, to the barn, which is over here. So I've got all the parts to them together. Here's the frame, the 14. Here's the brass tenor that I started making. And yeah, here are the Wickham diesels, which I honestly don't know if I showed them before, but they're Penline D2 Wickhams. Also got this really nice Rhinus O6OT from Thomas in a trade deal, which I'm pretty sure I've shown. Honestly, I have to go back and start watching all the videos to see what I've shown and what I haven't yet. Also from Ray, a couple of Roundhouse and Montua steam locomotives. Here's an old shifter I started restoring a while back. I rebuilt most of the running gear so far. Here's some more engines from Ray. There's 605's caboose. So yeah, there's not a whole lot of engines that I acquired. There's another one from Ray. But I'll probably show a couple of them in operation at the end of this video, along with the UP741. So yeah. One engine I forgot to mention was this awesome 3-truck Heisler locomotive, River Ossie, that I got from Ray in a trade deal. I had to build a new drawbar for it to connect the second and third truck. I added a couple brass detail parts to it, which I'm very happy with. New headlight, added a whistle, changed from the backup light used to be mounted on the cab. I made it go up on the tenor truck, which I like a lot better. Just need new couplers for it. It runs very well. Very happy with the results. Some other stuff I've got. Of course, all my other junk spread all across everywhere. Actually, put all my stuff into organized bins down here now. Between those bins, the layout, and here, I've got it pretty much all organized. Over 150 engines, I think, and 200 pieces of rolling stock, and like 70 coaches. There's just so much stuff for, you know, me.
Well, guys, I hope that explained pretty well things that have gone on and things that I've acquired and changed since the last video. I apologize if this was quite condensed and quite, you know, fast, not really that all in depth. It's just that I really don't have a whole lot to talk about, because quite honestly not a whole lot has changed. And I honestly don't know what I'm going to finish in the time that I'm still living here and still, you know, with the layout and everything, because it's really hard to tell. Like I said, a second roundhouse I probably will not acquire and build unless it became, unless one was right in front of me for a good price, but we'll see. The dual gauge, probably I'll do a little bit more, but I don't know if I'll do the entire main line, but that's another thing, like, we'll see. And, you know, I believe things like building more buildings or, you know, adding more scenery to places. I mean, it'll honestly be something to see, you know, a couple weeks, months down the line from now, because I generally cannot tell you at present time what the plan is, because I'm just kind of playing it by week. And only since I bought the brass UP741 for my birthday did I actually start coming back in here and not really working on things. I worked on it and a couple other engines, but cleaning things and getting things kind of ready to run again. I actually had three or four people from Facebook find me on Facebook and message me and ask if I was going to be doing any more videos soon. So that's kind of what prompted me to make this video, kind of just make another layout update. It most likely will not be my last video layout update, but maybe for a little bit while, because we'll see just what more I get done. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you have any questions, like always, just feel free to comment and I will respond to you. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and any more that I plan to make on certain layout projects and all that stuff in the past, into the future. So who knows, maybe I'll see you along down the line. Until then, see you next time.
If we roll down streets of fire, would you hold on to me tighter as the summer sun got higher? If we roll from town to town and never shut it down, would you go with me? If we were lost in fields of clover, we walk even closer until the trip was over. And would it be okay if I didn't know the way? If I gave you my hand, would you take it and make me the happiest man in the world? If I told you my heart couldn't beat one more minute without you, girl, you accompany me to the edge of the sea? Let me know if you're really a dream. I love you so, so would you go with me? Look down forever if you were lighter than a feather. Oh, and if I set you free, would you go with me? If I gave you my hand, would you take it and make me the happiest man in the world? If I told you my heart couldn't beat one more minute without you, girl, would you accompany me to the edge of the sea? Help me tie up the ends of a dream. I gotta know, would you go with me? I love you so.